Boom, hey internet. I got contacted by a barber who asked me the question for the video which you're clicking on. And let me say this, I got flown out to Connecticut a little bit ago because, as you know, if you are in the barbering world, and if you're not, walk with me, I did not know about it, so I was flown out to check out an expo, a convention that was happening in Connecticut. And prior to that, I had no idea of the subculture and the world that is barbering and hairstyling. It is very much a parallel to music, and social media-wise, I think that culture has its own subcultures, just like dancing does. I follow a lot of dancers, because I'm Filipino and all Filipinos dance. But a lot of Filipinos are barbers actually too. And I just want to say that the art in which, or what it has been elevated to in terms of an art form, is incredible. And so barbers who are, might be clicking on this for the content, this is an amazing world if you don't know about barbering and the competitions and the different categories that there could be within that art form. I do believe if I wasn't designing clothing, becoming a barber is definitely one route that I would definitely go towards and still might actually still might. I just see so much art in it, and it's great because you get to connect with people. In any case, having said that, the social media and the type of social media graph that you can have, the type of footprint that you can have, is actually huge, especially if you have skills and you have creativity. And a lot of people have elevated that so far and are pushing the limits of it. My case study for dance, for example, is Dietrix, who's now a judge and doing a lot of things on television. But prior to that, really taking the video and the media element and taking it as another element that you can then create with, rather than just always shooting the kind of haircuts that you do. Now, having said that, creating merch for a barbershop was the original question, and I'm gonna keep this video really basic per se and keep it very fundamental, because that's a loaded question. So that's like someone just asking me, how do you just start a clothing line? And that's why I have like 600 videos on this channel that talks about design, production, brand management, brand direction or art direction, e-commerce. All of those things are all pivotal as to launching a successful clothing brand. So this is slightly different because it's actually secondary to the main task, which is that person being a barber or a barbershop doing business and giving the service of haircuts and styling. And so I have two case studies that I want to bring up for this video. One is Mark the Barber, and the second is Sovi Pak, or Sophie. In the barbering world, y'all know her as just Sophie, or her AKA, which is Stay Gold 31. Both of them amazing barbers, both of them very, very accomplished, award-winning. They both speak, they're both educators. Mark is actually the homeboy. I've actually do know him, and so whenever I'm out in Florida, I try to come and connect with him. And the thing that I wanna bring up for these two as case studies in terms of merch is kind of backing it up before you launch any kind of merch for yourself or your barbershop. They went with names other than their government name, for example. So Mark has Blurry Fade. Everyone knows him as Mark the Barber, but his brand is Blurry Fades. So if you check him out on Instagram, you know, like Blurry Fades Barbershop, or if you know him for his expo, which is Blurry Fades Expo, everything has the same branding, okay? And if you're in that world, you know it's referring to an identity that is owned by Mark, but the branding takes a different name, okay? So there's a brand that he has kind of separately to push some of those things, and that you can then attach visuals to. So if you look at what he's done, so if we go to Blurry Fades Expo, for example, you can see that the graphic styling and the type of visuals he's using. If we go on the Instagram for Blurry Fades Barbershop, a lot of it is cuts, but even just some of the graphics he might use in between any of it kind of has the same visuals. You'll see the skull with the fade and the hair, which is an amazing graphic piece. And so all of that identity then attaches to it, and then it's easier to merch. So if we look at his merch page, you'll see that he's already put out t-shirts, and it's not t-shirts of him or Mark Marrero. It's not his name. It's Blurry Fades that he's branding. And so it gives you a different handle in which to approach it, and it kind of itemizes it so you know what that is. And I believe it's easier for a normal consumer to attach to that and just say, oh, I like that visual. I'm gonna cop that shirt. I'm gonna cop that beanie or hat or what have you. And simultaneously, he's able to expand that as a separate brand, okay? So for all my barbers, not just barbers, but other people, some people before have told me, subscribers on the channel have said, I wanna start a clothing brand with my name. Do you recommend it? Generally speaking, I say no. Even if you were a celebrity, even if you were like Logan Paul, let's say that for the YouTube world, Logan Paul, what is he at, 7-8 million subscribers? His clothing brand and his merch is not his name, okay? So just giving you that an example. If Brad Pitt asked me, I would not do a Brad Pitt line with his name. I would do a brand by Brad Pitt for his collection or what have you, or if it's a licensing deal with an existing brand. Know what I'm saying? So generally speaking, my advice is no. And that's also what my second case study for this video did. So Sophie Pak, everyone knows her as Sophie in the barber industry. She's an educator. She flies all around the world educating, and she's super amazing. By the way, related, but her styling, like just the way she dresses, is all killer, like crazy on the edge, very playful. She has a lot of different looks that she executes. If you go onto her Instagram and check out some of the content, you'll see what I'm saying, but really good look. And anyways, Staygold 31 is kind of what she has branded. As a designer, I love this for a number of reasons. Again, she's picking a name to be the brand. So if we go onto her website on staygold31.com and go to her shop, for her merchandise, she has a lot of different things. And I also want to point out, she diversified from just t-shirts and hats. Doing t-shirts, hats, beanies is like easy go-to for merch. If you think about it for an individual or a band or something like that. But doing pins, I love that she does pins. As a designer though, I can see a million different ways that she can put product out and go and put out a lot of different merch under that name and have it kind of live its own life, but it's all by Sophie. Also, if you check out her handle, like I said, on StayGold31, you can see some of the visuals. So as I said prior, like I love her styling, the way she dresses as a person. And so you have a lot to work with, because even the visual of her, whether she's educating or judging or being a part of an expo, being an ambassador of barbership in any way, she's gonna put out a different look. And so it really helps when someone is buying, because they're gonna affiliate her dope style to whatever she might put out for a collection or merch or just one garment or one piece. Even if she did a duffel bag, because she travels a lot, shooting her is gonna be great because she's gonna be a good visual. In any case, there's a lot to dissect there, but Mark the Barber for Blurry Fades and Sophie for Staygold 31, both great examples of the beginning of putting your merch together, because they kind of have a brand there that they can control separately and that they can do a lot of different things with. And so now putting the merch is a lot easier, and then putting it into your shop, which is probably a whole nother video for if we're talking about visual merchandising. I should make a video on that, because some people are making the worst mistakes with it in terms of presentation, and it doesn't take a lot. But remember, we buy things visually, so you have to properly put your merch out. And that's all I'm gonna say about that for this video, because that's a whole nother one. But making sure that brand is in place is a really good start for you to begin to roll out a collection or a capsule or just whatever garments that you might be thinking of putting out for yourself as a barber or your barbershop. Cool, hope that helps. Anything to add, any questions that you might have, as you guys already know, just drop it down below. I read it and then we can talk about it with the community. Like if you like, sub if you love, hit that bell for notifications so you get more from me, and follow me on social media when you get a chance. I'll see you guys on the next one, bye.